Hello, this presentation is going to review death and mortality measures. And before we begin, we're going to first define some concepts. First of all, a death is an event that marks the end of life that's measured by the heart not beating any longer and also verified in writing by a medical professional. Morbidity has to do with an abnormal or pathological state. It comes from the Latin basis for the word disease, morbus. And it's not necessarily associated with death, but is highly correlated. Mortality has to do with the process of depletion of a population. So the flow of individuals out of a population has to do with mortality, just as fertility has to do with the flow of people into the population. Longevity has to do with the ability to prevent death. This is sort of parallel to the term fecundity in terms of being a biological potential. How long can people live? And that's actually an empirical question. We have to look at the longest living humans to attempt to answer that, which I believe now is around 123 years. And then there's also the need to focus on the prevalence and incidence of causes of death. Those are, of course, related to morbidity. So the first measure we'll review is the crude death rate, and that has to do with the overall population and the number of deaths that occur per 1,000 people. There's also a variation called the central crude death rate that also takes into account prior and subsequent years in order to address variability and fluctuation that occurs. So it sort of smooths out the movement in the crude death rate across cohorts, perhaps. There's also specific death rates, just as there are specific birth rates and fertility rates that we examine. Specific death rates are for particular subpopulations, and of course those can be based on age or other criteria, such as ethnicity, perhaps, or sex. Age-specific death rates examine rates of death for particular groups, age intervals, used to calculate the total death rate, which is a parallel to the total fertility rate, which is the summing and averaging of the age-specific death rates. Same formula as a crude death rate, but only for a particular subpopulation that is defined by age interval. Morbidity rates are where we get into the prevalence and incidence measures. Prevalence has to do with the number of people with the disease relative to the total population. That again can be for the whole population or for specific subpopulations. Incidence has to do with the number of new cases. So not with the total number of people living it, but the total new cases of people living with a particular disease. And that informs research on major causes of death. Then we have a specific set of measures for young mortality rates, because these are the most puzzling, perhaps, and of course of great interest to researchers to mitigate and solve. Young mortality rates have to do with deaths of children under the age of 5. And overall, the young mortality rate is the number of under 5 deaths relative to population. So it's a particular type of specific death rate, mortality rate. The neonatal mortality rate has to do with the first 28 days of life. A lot can happen there. Infant mortality rate is up to the first year, and child mortality follows that through the end of the young mortality period, 1 through 5. If we drill into the infant mortality rate, we see that it's the sum of all those, the early neonatal, the neonatal, and the post-neonatal, which kind of breaks down infant mortality into three categories. A lot happens in the first 7 days. There's additional vulnerabilities that happen up through the first month. And then there are other vulnerabilities that happen after that through the first year. After that, we see the death rate trail off, but it is relative to subsequent age intervals, under 5 is a vulnerable time in our lives. We just don't have the resilience that older children have, young adults, than middle-aged adults. Related to these are the maternal mortality rate and fetal mortality rate, which is before birth, and those are, of course, other important measures. And that will conclude our discussion of death and mortality measures. Thanks for watching.